If we look at various types of machines, it is often found that there is a rotating shaft to transmit power from one part to another, or from a machine which produce power to a machine which absorb power. Because it rotates, the shaft inside the machine experiences friction with the machine housing, and the position of the shaft need to be kept stationary. Bearings are machine components that limit the motion of the shaft only to rotate and reduce the friction of the shaft when it rotates. So the energy transmitted through the shaft can be delivered as efficiently as possible. What makes rolling bearings reduce friction significantly? You can find the answer by looking at the working principle of the rolling bearings. Rolling bearings have a rolling element that separates the outer ring mounted on the engine housing from the inner ring mounted on the shaft. When the shaft rotates, the inner ring rotates while the outer ring is stationary because it is attached to the engine housing. This makes the rolling element rotate so that there is no friction between the surface or slip between the rolling element with the inner and outer rings. As a result, the energy loss due to the rotation of the shaft is minimal. Next, we will explain the components of a bearing. Bearings generally consist of four main components. The first is the inner ring. The inner ring is the ring that holds the shaft tightly, so this ring will rotate along with the rotary motion of the shaft. The second is the outer ring. The outer ring is the ring that attaches the bearing to the engine housing, so that the position of the shaft against the machine becomes steady. The third are the rolling elements. Rolling elements are the elements that roll between the inner ring and the outer ring because the inner ring rotates along with the rotation of the shaft. And the outer ring is stationary because it is connected to the engine housing. The fourth is the retainer. The function of the retainer is to maintain the distance between the rolling elements. But not all bearings have these four components. There are also bearings that only have two core components, namely rolling elements and retainer only, and do not have an outer ring and inner ring. One example is the following needle roller bearing type. The types of bearings can be classified from the shape of the rolling element, namely ball bearings and roller bearings. Ball bearings are the bearing that use rolling elements in the form of balls. Ball bearings are commonly used for shaft with light to medium loads and/or shaft that have medium to high rotational speeds. This is an example of ball bearing. Roller bearings are the bearing that use rolling elements in the form of cylindrical rollers, needle-shaped rollers, tapered rollers, and barrel-shaped rollers. Roller bearings are commonly used for shaft with medium to high loads and/or shaft that have low to medium rotational speeds. This is an example of cylindrical roller bearing. This is an example of needle-shaped roller bearing. This is an example of tapered roller bearing. This is an example of barrel-shaped roller bearing. shaped. In addition to the four main components of the rolling bearing, rolling bearings also have additional component, namely bearing cover. Open type bearings do not have cover to protect the rolling elements. This type of bearing is used in machine that already have a lubricant with lubricant filter or tightly closed condition, so that the lubricant that lubricates the bearing is clean and bearing does not need a cover. Shielded type bearings have a metal cover to protect the rolling elements, where the cover is made of metal that contacts the outer ring but does not make contact with the inner ring. This type of cover still allows lubricant to enter the bearing, but contaminants can still be filtered out. This type of cover is used on machines with bearing lubricant that still contains contaminants. Sealed type bearings have a seal cover to protect the rolling elements, where the cover is made of rubber or other elastic material which is in contact with the outer ring and inner ring. This type of cover completely covers the bearing and protects it from foreign oil, water and contaminants, all of which are from outside the bearing. This type of cover is used in machines where the bearing does not have external lubricant or the bearing is exposed to an external environment containing contaminants, water, foreign oil, etc. Because of its function to hold position of the shaft and reduce friction, bearings are used in almost all rotating part of machine. From the wheels of your car. The wind turbines for power generation. The ship system. Even on the airplanes that have moved people and goods from all over the world. Without bearing, these machines will stop operating and human life would be severely hampered by it. That's all about ball bearings and roller bearings. Thank you for watching my video. If you don't mind, click like and subscribe.